Well, yesterday we spoke with Lismore residents Mark and Leanne, who were winched from their rooftop by the Defence Force as floodwaters rapidly rose around them.
Along with Mark's son Chris, the three were saved just in time, but the family's dog DJ, who was sitting in a tinny next to the house roof, couldn't be rescued.
Branches were going everywhere and one hit the boat and my daughter's dog jumped out. Aww. Scared, he's jumped out. So I've gone to the side of the house, I've tried to grab him, I've grabbed a bit of hair on the back of his neck as he was going past and the hair's just ripped out. And he's gone under the veranda roof, so I was like punching out the clear sheets trying to find him. And I couldn't find him, eh? And then the guy's saying, we've got to go. So we had to leave him there.
Oh, no.
But all these people out there, like these two amazing ladies, and I'm sorry, I can't remember their names, there's so many people. Christy, I think, is one of them. One of them's in Melbourne, and I don't even know where the other lady is, but they're coordinating all the boats rescues out our way at the moment. And I'm actually going from this interview, a guy's coming from Tweed, to Dave, his name is. He's coming down with a boat and a jet ski. He's picking me up, and we're going back out to try and find DJ because apparently he was spotted about 2 p.m. yesterday, still alive.
Well, Mark headed out after our interview yesterday, and a miracle happened. Mark joins us now along with his daughters, Eliza, Cheyenne, and you've got someone with you, Mark, this morning.
Yeah, we've got the famous dog at the moment.
Oh! DJ.
Oh, wow.
How's he doing?
He's
doing pretty good. He's pretty tired, though. Yeah, exhausted. He's so happy to be home. He's non-stop been wagging his tail.
He was so hungry and thirsty.
Oh, look, we actually have the moment on camera when you were reunited with DJ. Let's have a look at that one.
Oh, yes, DJ. Oh, yes, mate. You made it, mate. Little bugger over there goes. Oh, DJ. Oh, mate. My boy, you made it. Oh, you made it. Hey. Your man Sean's going to be so happy. Oh, mate, you're such a survivor. Hey, you're a celebrity. You're all over the news.
Oh, my Lord, what a beautiful moment.
You've absolutely broken us with that video. Wow, where was he?
That was another amazing part of this whole ordeal. Where we found him, he was like at least 400 metres upstream. So he's gone against the current, which was unbelievable. Like, my son's caravan was beside the house and it took off, and within about 3.5 metres, his caravan travelled over 1.5 k. So DJ swam against that. I found him on a big pile of what might have been a shed or something, big pile of rubble. I was wading in water going inland because we heard it after about half an hour or so of yelling and that around, couldn't hear nothing. Then we've heard what we thought was a dog howling in the distance. So the boys jumped on the jet ski in the boat and they headed upstream, and I said, I'll go inland. And I got up to, you know, up to about waist in water, and I thought, nah, what am I doing? You know, I must have heard something, he's not here. And I was kind of just about giving up, and I just had a feeling, I've turned to me right and up through the trees, and that I could make out a dog in sitting on something. And then our neighbour's dog had this, he looked similar to our dog, so I'm going, no, don't get your hopes up. It's not DJ, it's probably the neighbour's dog. And as I've got closer, I've realised it was DJ, and he was just sitting there like, you know, I'd just come back from town for the day, you know. He was just happy to see me, a bit cranky that I'd left him there so long, but he was happy to see me.
We were absolutely heartbroken after hearing your story today, and that video is absolutely unbelievable. Cheyenne, how happy are you? I mean, was there moments when you'd given up hope that DJ would be coming home?
Before we got the news about he was spotted, I was starting to give up hope. But once I heard that, I was starting to, you know, realise that he could still be out there. And when we finally got reunited, I was so excited, like, and amazed. that how, like, in good condition he is.
Oh, that's how resilient. So
how
beautiful
proud
to
was
hear.
He and happy to see you as
can,
well, mate.
Can you quite believe how invested so much of the country is and was in finding DJ? I mean, watching those live rescue pictures going live to air, watching your dad being winched to safety, seeing DJ in the back of the titty, his tail just going, and then all of a sudden he disappeared, and we were just all thinking, what's happened to the dog? So many people are invested in this.
Yeah, so many people were worried and concerned. And
And we all thought that he got put in the bag that went up.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what some people were thinking in that.
Well, I think this story is almost like a beacon of hope for everyone else who might be in a similar situation. Seeing these stories of resilience, it was the result that everyone wanted, obviously for your family as well, but for everyone to kind of continue hope.
Go ahead, Mark.
Yeah, well, that's what Dave and I, when we were heading up on the jet ski yesterday, like when we were getting closer, we were getting into where we thought our place was, we were just losing hope and thinking, like, how are we going to find him in amongst all this? Like, you know, and I'm starting to think, look, I've wasted these resources. We should be, you know, doing other things for other people. And, you know, and that's what Dave and I were saying, like, geez, if we don't find him, you know, that's just, you know, one beacon of hope for people. And if we don't find him, you know, these small things mean a lot. And then when we found him, we just thought, well, you know, that's some miracle out of all this that's happening. You know, that'll give people hope that more miracles are going to happen. You know, more good things, you know, small good things will come out of this, you know, and give people that hope to keep going and keep trying, you know.
Yeah.
And, geez, all the people that were helping and that, you know, like Dave, he come down from the Gold Coast, these two other boys, Saxon, and I'm sorry, I'm forgetting the other boy's name. If it wasn't for them two, they knew, they got us up there. Like, well, otherwise we wouldn't have even found where our creek was. You know, it was amazing, absolutely amazing, you know, and I thank all the people and all the private people that are out there on boats. Like, there was hundreds of people on boats out there yesterday. It was overwhelming.
And
it was absolutely amazing.
It's important for people to know at home, Mark, that you have lost so much as well. Your car went underwater. So this is a bright spot in your home.
We've lost everything.
Yeah, and this is a bright spot in what's been such a hard week.
I was, you know, at the beginning there when we were yelling out and that, and then I've gone in the house because we had chooks in the house. And most of our chooks survived, but when I was walking through the house and that, like, you know, it was unbelievable. Like, the whole house is just destroyed. Leanne, the owner of the property, her house, the only reason I knew where her house was and her big shed is her car's there. Her whole house is completely gone. The shed you could see in a big twisted pile in the paddock, you know, that's 78 years of her life is gone. And, like, our house is just totally devastated. And, you know, but then when I found DJ, I just thought, for the moment, you know, who cares? You know, like, we've got DJ, you know.
It is. Yeah. It's the most extraordinary story. And you are such a character, Mark, as well. When we spoke to you earlier in the week, you said that you'd lost your teeth as well. Did you find your teeth?
Yeah, and then when I was there with my Land Cruiser, it's locked itself, and I couldn't get into it. And so I still haven't got any.
Oh, you know, we might try and work on that one for you, Mark. Ladies, wow, what a story! We're so glad you've been reunited with your dog, beautiful DJ, the very best boy.
Yeah, no, it's amazing. All last night, like, I couldn't sleep. But all last night, DJ had just come up and put his paw on me, or I'd, you know, doze off and then wake up again, he'd be just sitting there staring at me, you know. He's an amazing dog before this. Like, he practically talks to you. He's amazing, you know.
You're an amazing family, and you've brought so much. And you've brought smiles to
people. And we're going back.
At a hard time. You're going back in today.
And we're trying to go back out there. Yeah, Dave's coming down, so we're going to go back out later on the jet ski, because I've got a list of, there's like 20-something dogs, 30 cats and that are still out on our, that's just on our road.
Wow. So we're going out there
because no vehicles will get in there for two and...
Yeah.
Yeah, well, we did after we got DJ yesterday. We went, because a neighbour had heard through social media and she had two Great Danes out there. So we went out after we got DJ, went about another 3 Ks up the river, and we found her Great Danes. They're very ferocious, but we coaxed them down and we fed them and got to pat them, but we couldn't get them in the boat. But they're on dry land, they're fine, and I've sent the photos to the owners and they're thanking me so much. But yeah, we gave them a lot of food and we'll get back out there again and feed them up again until we can get them out of there.
Do you know what? We're very proud of you. You've given everyone a lot of hope this morning and you're going back out to continue to give them help.
Yeah.
We couldn't be any happier for you guys.
Yeah, thank you.
Great to see DJ home.
Thank you.
Thank you. Right. Yeah, be safe again. For sure. Aww.